Students, good morning. Yesterday we have learnt what is a linear equation. A linear equation in one variable, and some more examples have been seen in graph. We have known that a linear equation which is one variable must be parallel to y axis and parallel to x axis, and whereas a line which passes by slanting have two variables, equation in two variables, that we have seen by showing two examples. Now I am going to give one more example and going into 6.1 exercise. Now, yesterday we have taken and generalized a linear equation in two variables is ax plus by plus c equals to 0 is the general form of the straight line. What is that? Ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is the general form of straight line that we have derived yesterday. Now we know that a and b and c are 3. What is that? A and b and c are 3 real numbers. Then ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is a linear equation. Now I want to say some more examples, and which are in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. In the given what is the term? In try this 6.1. Before 6.1 there is a express the following linear equation in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0 and indicate the values of a, b, c in each case. For example, what is it? Try this. In try this, we have example 1, 3x plus 2y equal to 9. Is it in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0? Yes, x term is there, y term is there, c term is there. But whereas c term is in right side of the equation. Now if we write 3x plus 2y minus 9 equal to 0 is now in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. What we asked here? Express the following linear equations in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Yes. Now we wrote that in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. All three terms are in left side. Now what is a? A means 3, coefficient of x, and b equal to 2, and c equal to minus 9. Very easy. Now one more question. Minus 2x plus 3y equals 6. Minus 2x plus 3y equals 6. Minus 2x plus 3y equals 6. Yes, how it is? Is it in the form of this? No. Why? Because c is in right side. Now it has been taken into left side. Minus 2x plus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. Yes, now what we write? A equal to minus 2 and b is equal to minus plus 3 and c equal to minus 6. So this is a very easy to identify and to understand. Now one more example is here. Now I am taking fourth one. Third is easy. What is that? x by 2 minus 5 by 3 is minus 5 equal to 0. Yes, what is A, what is B and what is C? Simple, A is equal to, here x coefficient is 1 by 2, and y coefficient here 1 is there, symbol is minus, B is equal to minus 1 by 3, am I right? And C is equal to minus 5. Yes. Now, one more example, 2x equal to y. Don't you write this as 2x? We have to take this into the left side. 2x minus y equal to 0, a equal to 2, and b is equal to minus 1, and c equal to not there, so that c equal to 0. Simple. Now, going into exercise 6.1. Now, what is the problem? Express the following linear equations in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0 and indicate the values of a, b, c in each case. Simple. Very easy. What we did is try this. Like that, there are x by 3 plus y by 4 equal to 7. Now I am taking fifth question. Very easy. X by 3 plus y by 7. Y by 4 equal to 7. Write it in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. How do we write here? A denominator is there for first term and the second term is also there. Very easy to write. Now c is to be taken into left side. What happens? Or now I write directly a equal to 1 by 3, b equal to 1 by 4, and c equal to, if we take to left side, it becomes minus 7. Now I want to write in this form so that 3 comma 4, LCM is 12. For LCM 3 and 4 is 12. 3, 4 is 12, no? 4, 3 is 4 index, 4x. Again, once again, 3, 4 is 12 is LCM. Again by first fraction, dividing 12 by 3, 3 how much is 12? 4 is 4 into x, 4x plus 4 how much is 12? 3 is next 3 into y, 3y equal to 7. Now 4x plus 3y equal to 12, 7 84. If we transpose 12 to right side, it becomes into 12 to 7. 12, 7 is 84. Now taking to left side, 4x plus 3y minus 84 equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Now a equal to 4 and b is equal to 3 and c is equal to minus 84. So this is the conversion. In the given equation, it has to be converted in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Very simple. Now I want to write one more question, that is, write each of the following in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0 and find the values of a, b, c. Very simple, same question. Asking the same like this. Do we want to know y equal to minus three by 2x? Now we want to write that in the form of ax plus by plus c equals to 0. What happens? There is by 1, 2 is transposed to left, 1 is transposed to right. What happens? 2 into y, 2y equal to here 1, 1 into minus 3x, minus 3x. Minus 3x is taken to left side, bar becomes plus 3x plus 2y equal to 0. Very simple. Minus 3x taken into left side becomes plus 3x plus 2y equal to, no term in there, right side, after taking minus 3x into left side, left is 0, 0 is left. So that, now what I write, a equal to 3 and b equal to 2, c is not there, so that c equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c 0 equal to 0. Okay, simple. Next, going to one more question, that is same as this. How? Here x is equal to minus 14 by 13. X is equal to minus 14 by 13. Yes. Write it in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Very easy to write how 13 has been transposed to left side. 13 into x, 13x equals to minus 14. Is it okay? Next. 13x taking to left side plus 14 equal to 0. Now a equal to 13 and b equal to, y term is not there. Y term is not there, so that b equal to 0 and c is equal to plus 14. In another way, I want to say one more answer. X is equal to minus 14 by 13. No? It is completely a constant term. Taking to left side, what becomes x plus 14 by 13 equal to 0. We want to consider a means 1, no, nothing, the coefficient x means result 1, and b means y is not there, y term, so that b value is 0, and constant, that is c, equal to 14 by 13. So what is the difference here? A equal to 13 we got here, but A equal to 1, but C equal to 14 by 13. We want to convert AX plus BY plus C equal to 0 form so that denominator should not be left. The equation must be in the form of AX plus BY plus C equal to 0 so that now I have to transpose 13 to left side, becomes 13 into x, 13x, minus 14 will be left. That minus 14 has to be transposed to left side, becomes plus 14. Yes, now we got ax plus b not there, means y term is not there in the given equation, so that b value is 0 and c means constant, that is plus 14. Yes, shall we consider that here values of same question are I equal 32, A equal 1, B equal 0, and C equal 49, C equal 20. Yes, by simplifying we get the values of A and B and C same as those results. Next. Third question, very simple. Question number third. Express the following statements as a linear equation in two variables. Yes, sir. Statements are given. The given statement has to be formed as a linear equation as ax plus by plus c equal to 0. For example, question number 1 is given as the sum of two numbers c is 34. The sum of two numbers is 34. Very simple. See, in this chapter, we have to follow one thing, that is, in the given statement, the sum of two numbers are not there, but the result is 34. Where E is given, it means equal to. It means equal to. So the left side to is what is the statement? The sum of two numbers. Yes, two numbers are not there. As we are in linear equations, so that now I take x is one number and another number b y. Sum means addition. So that x plus y equal to 34. Very simple to understand, means the sum of two numbers are not there. Now let one number be x and the second be y. As our problem, the sum of two numbers x plus y. Now I said is means equal to, it is 34. But now I want to see this equation in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Now this equation I want to see in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Yes, x and y terms are there in left side, but whereas c is right side to equal, but c is in left side here. Now I want to see 0 the right side, so that it should be taken into left side. X plus y minus 34 equal to 0. Yes, a means 1, b means 1, c means minus 34. Ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Very simple. The given statement is to be converted in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. The same statement like what is given. The cost of a ball pen is 5 rupees less than half of the cost of a fountain pen. Now I write the question. The cost of a ball pen is 5 less than half of the cost of a fountain pen. There are two things. Like earlier problem, there are two numbers not given, taken as x and y. Here there are two things, there are two numbers, here two things. One is a ball pen and another one is a fountain pen. What is the relation between these two pens? There in the earlier problem, the relation between x and y is a sum. Addition is given, the total is 34 is given. But the relation is what here? The cost of a ball pen is, yes, is means what? Equal to. How do we write? Yes, 5 rupees less than half of the cost of a fountain pen. 5 rupees is less. It means the more value, more 5 rupees more of this fountain pen. Now what I take, I recognize here two things. One is a ball pen. Yes, now what I write, cost of let the cost of a ball pen be x and fountain pen and fountain pen cost be what? Y is direct, like not listen. The cost of a ball pen is ball pen taken x equal. See, by reading the statement, easy to write. The cost of a ball pen is, ball pen cost is taken as x, is what? 5 less. How 5 less? The cost of half of the cost of a fountain pen. Yes, half of the cost of y by 2, half of cost of what is that? Half means half of fountain pen is given now. Yes, now 5 less again. Very simple. Here equal is given, taken. The next statement has to be understood clearly. 5 less than half of the cost of fountain pen. Now this is this in the form of ax plus b plus c equal to 0? Not. Is it in the form of, no, not there, so that what to do? Now I write y by 2 to left side, or two terms taken to left side, x minus y by 2 plus 5 equal to 0. Do you agree with me what I did? 5y by 2 taken to left side, minus y by 2. Minus 5 taken to left side, plus 5. Now, denominator, I do not like the denominator to be, yes, 1, 2, 1, yes, it is 2. Dividing by 1, this 1, how much are? 2 is 2x minus 2, how much are? 1 is 1y, no need to write 1 into y, y only. Next, plus 1, how much are? This 2 is 2, 5 is 10 equal to 0. Now 2x minus y plus 10. 2 is transposed into left right side, 2 into 0 or 0 into 2. 2x plus minus y, 2x minus y plus 10 equal to 0. Yes, we got that is 2x minus y plus 10 equal to 0. In the form of ax plus b plus c equal to ax, plus means here minus, got minus b means 1, minus 1, plus c means 10 only. It's very easy. Now I write one more question, that is a very simple shall I say, each and every problem in the exercise, no need, very simple to understand. Yes, okay, one more question. The cost of a pencil is, the cost of a pencil is rupees what? 2 and a ballpoint pen. And a ballpoint pen is rupees 15. Sheila pays 100 rupees per pencil. 100 rupees for pencil and pen she purchased. 100 rupees per purchase. Okay. Very simple. The cost of a pencil is rupees 2 and a ballpoint pen is rupees 15. In the earlier problems I told is means equal, but not here. The cost of a pencil is 2 rupees. And there is one more. Here a pencil is there and a ballpoint pen is there. Their cost is given, but the number of pencils are not given. Pencils are number of pound ballpoint pens are given. But she paid 100 rupees for both the pencils and the pens. But how many pencils she bought, we didn't know. And how many ballpoint pens she bought, we don't know. So that number of pencils will be x. Let number of pencils be x, and number of ballpoints. Number of ballpoint pens be y. Yes. Sheila pays to the shopkeeper. If she purchased 2 pencils, 2 to the 4 rupees she will give. If she purchased 5 pencils, 5 to the 10 rupees she will be paid. If she bought the pencils or 20 to the 40 rupees she wants to pay. So that what to do? 2 into x means number of, means the total amount of the, what is it, cost of pencils. What amount she want to pay for pencils means x into 2. So that 2x plus, and here number of pens are y now. 15 rupees once one ballpoint pen cost. If she bought 2 pens, 250 is 30 rupees. Means what you doing? 15 into 2 rupees, 2 means 15 rupees, 30. If she bought 3 pens, 350 is 45 rupees. If she bought 5 ballpoint pens, 5 to 15, 75 rupees. So that y into 15, that is equal to 15y. The total cost will be what? 100. It is equalizing. Now this is an equation of required statement. Ax plus by it equal to 100. Now taking to left side, 2x plus 15y plus minus 100. It is positive now. When we transpose to left, it becomes minus. Yes. 2x plus 15y minus 100 equal to 0. It's very simple to understand. Next, there are remaining two problems in this 6.1 exercise. Solution of linear equations in two variables. Okay. Next, solutions of linear equations in two variables. Solutions of a linear equation in two variables. Okay. Yesterday I told that x equal to 4, the line of equation, what I draw here, line of this equation is, the name of this line is x equal to 4. What I told yesterday, a linear equation which has in one variable has a unique solution, means do not have more than one, so that give many examples to identify. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here it becomes the point is 4, 1. Here it is 4, 2. Here it is 4, 3. It is 4, 4. Here it is 4, 5. And 4, 6. There are, a line is forming by set infinite set of points. There are infinite set of points on x equal to 4 line. But what is the solution means? A point which on the same line, which satisfies the line equation, is called the solution. Now x equal to 4, 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 x equal to 4. The first coordinate of each point is written as 4. So that if we put x equal to 1, do not equalize it. So that x equal to 1 is not the solution. When we put x equal to 4, yes, 4 equal to 4. 4 equal to 4 means equation is satisfied. The linear equation, when it is satisfied by giving the values to the variable, when it is satisfies the value is part of the solution of that equation. But whereas in solutions of a linear equations in two variables, now I explain it here for one variable equation. There here we have two variables. For example, 3x minus 4 equal to 8. 3x minus 4 equal to 8. How many variables are there in this equation? First of all, we have to identify the equation. How many variables are there? Only one. So that it must have only one solution. That is 3x is equal to 8 plus 4. Transpose 4, right side. Becomes 3x is equal to 12. X is equal to 12 by 3. The 1 the 4 the x equal to 4. Yes, what I taken here, same probabilities are given in our textbook. 3x minus 4 is equal to 8. By solving x value, we got x equal to 4. Yes. The solution is 4. Solution is 4. Now what? Write that 4 comma 0. Here the point 4 comma 0. 0 means what? Y coordinate for this point. Next, one more example let me give you here. 3x minus 2y equal to 5. How do we find the linear solution of this linear equation? How many we got? For this line x equal to 4, we have only one solution, that is unique solution 4. Here how many solutions we get and what is the feasibility? Now I put x equal to 0, what happens? 3 into 0 minus 2y equal to 5. 3 into 0 means 0 only. No need to write 2y equal to 5. Y equal to 5 by minus 2. Coefficient one, so that becomes a denominator. Result is minus 5 by 2. What is solution? Solution is x taken 0. Actually solution is x comma y. X means 0, y means minus 5 by 2. Sir, we discussed a straight line has a number of infinite set of points on a line, so that don't we get one more point? If you put x equal to 1, what happens? 3 into 1, listen me, 3 into 1 minus 2y equal to 5. 3 1s are 3 minus 2y equal to 5. Minus 2y equal to transposing becomes minus 3. Minus 2y equal to plus 2. 5 minus 3 means 2 now. Y equal to 2 by minus 2. 2 to get cancelled. Y equal to get means 2 1 the 2 1 the 2. 1 by 1. Minus is there. Minus 1 by 1 means 1. Minus 1. What is the solution? X taken 1. Y what? Minus 1. As this substitution, x equal to 0 taken, result is minus 5 by 2. X equal to taken as 1, y value minus 1 got. If we put x equal to 2, the y value will be different. And x equal to 3, we get y value different. So that how many solutions do we get? There are so many solutions, sir. Maybe like it goes. Yesterday I told in the introduction, a straight line which has some kind of slanting position have two variables in x and y. So that solutions of a linear equation in two variables observed as infinite number of solutions. What we got? A linear equation which is in two variables have infinite set of solutions. Very easy to say. Now, do we want to find one more point solution? Yes. By taking minus value, what we get? What is the problem? 3x minus 2y equal to 5. Now put 2x equal to what? Yes, now I want to take minus 2. What happens? 3 into minus 2 minus 2y equal to 5. X means minus 2 criteria. 3 into the minus 6 minus 2y equal to 5. minus 2y equal 5 plus 6, minus 2y equal to 11, y equal to 11 by minus 2. So minus 2r minus 11 by 2 is the same. Solution means what? X is taken as minus 2, y got minus 11 by 2. Okay. Yes. Solution means what? Solution means minus 2 comma minus 11 by 2 is a point on the straight line. 1 comma minus 1 lie on the straight line. And before this point we got as a 0 comma something we got here. That is also on the same line. The points which are on the same line are called solutions of the given equation. Okay.